Hi, Gemini. Don't worry, be happy. Everything is gonna be just fine. Don't worry, don't be happy. Everything is gonna be just fine. I didn't know this was changing in your relationship. Evidence. Ooh, I like this. This feels like punches. Yes, I'm the same 555. You may also be saying 411. Oh, that's where the 411 came from. Because I got 411 at first. I was like, 411. I was feeling like it was a song, but I was just saying 411, like information committee. You guys are getting the evidence. You're getting the evidence, so let's see, what, where are you getting this evidence from? You're getting the proof of who people are. You're seeing the proof of who people are. There's no hiding, like you're seeing them live and they're right, like, oh, okay, so this is all you're about. Interesting, okay. For some of you, I'm seeing like you went to look for answers. Actually went to research, went to do your findings. But then others of his, like, the evidence are just falling in your lap. Like, you're just saying, oh, so this is who this person is. So this is how this person takes me. So this is how this person sees me. This is how this person behaves. This is how this person, there's also something about mentality. Gemini, you guys are really getting an idea of people's mental states. And also like their maturity levels. There's something about, it's almost like you're being given the ability to see into people's thinking patterns. And you're like, oh, this person, so this is how they think. Oh, so this is how this person behaves. Oh, so this is how this person thinks. And there's just something funny about it, like you. So that's why I said it's very, just very few of you that, it's very few of you that went out to looking for this evidence. Most of it is just like this thing just comes into your lap and like you're being given the background, backhand view. Like you're being able to peer into people's brains and then you're seeing how the synapses, how the synapses are joining, how the neurons are firing. You're seeing what part of the brains are firing. You're like, ah, so this is how this person thinks. So this is how this person thinks. So good for you. So let's get some more clarity on this person. Okay, so my generous, these are people you perhaps work with, people you partner with in your business. This is people you maybe like your clients, people you work with, your community, your colleagues, the people you roll around with in your industry, in your niche. For some of you, these are people you break bread with, you dine with, okay? So you might not necessarily be colleagues, but maybe you may talk frequently to talk about work, so like industry setting, right? There's just a lot around. There's something coming through around people underestimating you. And then because of how you're showing up, you're now able to clearly see people for who they are because they've underestimated you. So it's almost like they've played their hands. They've overplayed their hands. So now you're seeing everything like, oh, so that's how the person is interested. This person, so might have overplayed their hands in terms of your assets and income, thinking they could stop your bread. Like, what I'm getting is like, they wanna stop my shit, but they don't know. This vibe is like people underestimated you, and now you're showing up 4:40 of my time. You guys may be saying 5:55 a lot. I just realized this is also 5 of coins. And now you're showing up and you're like, and they're baffled, like. Okay, we thought wrong, and now you because of the play their hands, you're able to really, really see them for who they are. Able to really, really see them for who they are. So for some, this is just very emphasized on people who are trying to affect your income source. People who are trying to affect your bread, your bag, whatever you call money, your coins, your flow of income. This is a person thinking that whatever plans they made for you, that you're going to fall into a trap and there'll be no way out. And then, but then, what I'm saying is that they were thinking you take the stairs, but spirit had prepared an escalator for you, so you're just moving and you're looking down them like, oh, so you thought you could play me like that? You thought. Okay, you thought you could play me like that? No, the evidence is stacking up and it's like it's in your favor. And you're realizing that it feels good, you kept true to yourself. Let's see, any other thing around this person? It was good you kept true to yourself. But these were people that wanted to affect your back. But now, like, evidence is stacking up. You are who you said you've been. And those that be lying is now coming true. World card. You're a star, baby. You're a star. Alright, so you've got world card of weapon. So what I'm saying is also like, I mean, can you see the radiation? It's like things are now coming to light and people can see it for who you truly, and then it's like it's now who you are contrary to what has been said about you, and that's what the evidence that is being stacked up is all about. Okay, you've always been who you are, and then that's just coming through. And that's very good. And it's also giving you the opportunity to like position yourself better and just be like, okay. And as I said, you're seeing people's true colors. Yes, you're seeing people's true patterns. So nothing is really. No, it's like you're just sitting more comfortably on your throne, in your space, in your throne, on your chair. Nothing is shaking. You know who you are now. You know who is who. You know how people think, you know how their mental patterns are, you know all of those things. So you're not even allowing you to distract you from what you have to do. Okay? Star. Okay? So even though you may feel like you're sitting by yourself, what I'm also hearing is that there's no space for two on the throne. You're showing up as the master now. And people just have to take notice. And those who thought you couldn't, they are the ones who evidence is stacking up against. But now you're being seen as the master. You're being seen as the expert. You're being seen as the guide. As one who has wisdom to offer. You're being seen as the guide, as one who has wisdom to offer. You guys are saying 555 is a lot. This is another 5. Okay, so through this time, we've also learned, spirit has also been teaching you about how to value yourself, how to honor yourself, how to stay true to who you are, how not to be deceitful or to overplay people or to try to manipulate things. So all this while, you've just really been learning how to, for some of you, this might have been happening in the past 5 years. 5 years is very significant. I'm going to say 5 months, but they keep going back to 5 years. So these are changes you've been undergoing in the last 5 years. Having to drop everything that you are not so that you can show up as who you truly are. And now people are starting to take notice of it. It's becoming recognized. You're going global. You're going to places. Your names are being mentioned in the rooms you've never been to. You're showing up as the master, you're showing up as the expert. Let's see, is there anything we need to continue to do at this time? And I'm also getting a message from your ancestors. And also something from your soul. Let's see your soul actually. I have so many decks out in the open, they're like exciting. Is there anything you need to continue to do now? As you become this master, as you take up this role, as you continue to shine, is there a message from your higher self? Is there a message from your higher self now? I'm also being guided to tell you to relax more, stress less, give yourself enough time to replenish, to rebuild, to re-energize your energy. As a master, as an expert, there's a lot more you know now than you knew before. Give yourself the grace to integrate those new learnings, your new awareness. You're the master now, you're not the apprentice, so you should be more of higher other skills, higher level learning, more strategic, less tactical. Do you understand? Big message from the higher self. These guys may also be pulled to pearls, wanting to wear pearls, wanting to buy pearls. Round, perfectly formed, natural pearls, if you can find fresh water pearls. Okay? Trust your path. If you knew you would be supported, what would you do? Priestess, are you being called to step up and lead? So as I said, you guys, you're really in that place of leadership now. You're the guide. You're the guide. You're the one providing clarity for others. You're the one teaching others. You're the one advising them. You're the one providing spiritual guidance and enlightenment. Okay, that's your role now. So trust your path. Relax on your path. If you knew you would be supported, what would you do? If you knew you'd be supported, what would you do? What would you do that you keep stopping yourself from doing because you're seeing there's no support? If you knew the support was inherent, because the support is, spirit has got your back, ancestors have spoken, they've got your back. If you knew the support was there, what would you do? How would you show up more? How would you show up better? How would you sit up more comfortably in your throne? How would you take up more space? How would you take up more presence? Let's see, a message from your ancestors. Live out loud. Live out loud, baby. Now there's no more hiding space for you. You've seen the evidence. You've seen who you are. You've learned more about yourself. People have also seen who you are. Now it's time for you to step up to level two. Level two. Live out loud. No hiding. Do what you need to do for yourself. Make the noise you need to make. Show up as you want. Okay, so two things are connected. Initially they said you've earned the right, but on the other hand, they are not wanting to see that something you earned, it has always been your birthright. So it's like you've earned your birthright, but it was never for you to earn, it was just for you to remember and own. It's always been yours. Do you understand? Yashigi, live out loud. Fearless love. Seven sisters, creativity, and universe, sacred lust. Lilith is also being very strongly activated for you guys right now. Lilith is in Libra, but then she's also helping you to be very unconventional, very wild, really doing things your way, because now you know that's what you need to do. It's your path. There's no one else that can walk your path. There's no one else that can do what you're doing. So now you're being invited to take pride and take ownership of your creativity. Your creativity is also very, there's something about you guys being, yeah, I know Gemini is already multi-dimensional, multi-potential, multifunctional. But now your creativity is even going to new levels. before you've been playing at beginner's level, now you're like, and so in some areas you're like the expert, in some areas you're still, you know, finding your feet, but you are more grounded and more stable in your essence. You're more grounded and more stable in your essence. So there's just something about being very wild, being very free, opening yourself up, embracing all of who you are. Embracing all of who you are. As I said, pearls. I told you pearls, right? Can you see? I just feel pulled back to this pearl. Pearl, moonstone, opals, but mostly pearl. Pearl is what just keeps pulling through. Be proud of who you are. Be proud of what you can do. Nobody else can do what you can do the way you do what you can do. The way you do you. Once a fall, when you. Okay? Or show fearless love. Yes, I'm also feeling, seeing you pulled to purpose, but more like, not exactly wearing them, but more like seeing yourself in that regal, having that regal presence and state of mind, like, okay, I have so much power, and I'm doing that chooses how to wield it, so how I show up, I carry myself with pride, with my backbone straight up. My chest out, my head held high. So that's where I'm feeling the regality. You guys may also be you may be feeling pulled to wearing like very velvety, rich materials, rich colorful fabrics. Colors, yeah, a lot of colors, as I said, because I'm just saying like all the colors here. You need all the mixture of colors, all the brightness, okay? So this is you guys. So you may be filled to wearing colors, but there's just something also about the texture of your fabric. It's maybe like just something very, very rich textures, not dry plains. Textures that have layers. Do you understand? You're feeling that pull. And let's see. What can you expect over the next? What can you expect over the next 6 months? As you continue to, what I'm just saying is, you just stepping more into your power, remembering more of who you are, stepping more into leadership roles, taking the lead, trusting your intuition, trusting your guts, letting your creativity shine and spill out from you. Just continuing to step up and step into that role, okay? Stepping up as the guide, stepping up as the mentor, as the one with the advice, you know, just stepping up into that role. Let's see, is there any other thing you need to look forward to the relationships? Thank you. Okay. Okay, that's it. They're not giving me anything else. There's also something about you, like finally closing a chapter of where you played small, of where you didn't even know your power, like putting that chapter of your life to rest, because you're no longer that person. The person was afraid to speak up, the person who didn't want to shake the tables, the person didn't want to stand in their role or recognize their role as the guide, as the expert, as the leader, as the priestess. Yeah, closing that chapter. There's no looking back anymore. You're looking back. Okay, this is fearless self-love. Geminis, this period for you just showing you how to love yourself more, how to silence your naysayers simply from the fact that you love yourself, so you show up as who you are. And as I said, claiming your birthright, because this has always been you. Trust your path. If you knew you'd be guided, if you knew you'd be supported, what would you do? Ask yourself that every time you come to a point or a level that feels like, oh boy, maybe some anxiety or some doubts gripping you, just ask yourself, hey babe, but I know I'm supported though, so I know the support is always still, so what is this? And my final message for me, this was kind of my final message for my sweet gentleman. Final message from the sweet Gemini. Thank you. call back my power. Part of the phone when you also received is you realizing like, oh, there are some people you thought were better than you, or some people you unconsciously looked up to, and you're realizing like, okay, you guys are actually different. There's some people you've unconsciously raised into pedestals, or you put on pedestals in your life in terms of authority figures, but now you're realizing, oh, okay, I didn't need to do that. I myself am the one I need to put on a pedestal in my life, not anybody else. Okay, so that's the one answer. You guys are reevaluating your relationship with authority figures, maybe in your industry, in your niche, and you're like, okay, no. Because what that is doing is that it's keeping you playing small, thinking like there's still something for you to learn. What you need to learn is on your own path, not what anybody else out there has done. What you need to learn is how you do what you need to do, your own unique way of doing what you need to do, what needs to get done. So call back your power. There's also something about calling back your power from, it's like also maybe relationships you're involved in. Now you're like pulling your power back to yourself. You're using it to charge yourself from missing. So there was a, should I say, a mini lecture I gave. It was like a lecture, it was like, it wasn't a reading, it was a pure educational session. And it was around how sex can be used to charge up your inner battery. But for you, what I'm feeling is like, you're not even, if you were sexual before, you're becoming less sexual, less sexual, because you're pulling in that energy for yourself. You're activating your sacral energy, the engine, the rotor in your sacral chakra. Is reflecting based on your own innate power. So you're not here for anybody else at you to charge up. You're actually charging yourself, like self-recharging battery for the next 6 months. Now I'm not saying you guys will be celibate. Some of you will be celibate. Some of you will be wildly lustful. But even in the lust, you guys, so if you're a partner to Gemini, So Gemini is that single. You guys are going to be more celibate because you're keeping your power to yourself. You really don't even want to share it. But those that are already in relationships, if you partner to Gemini, expect them to become more lustful. It's like they're going to become more sexual. They're going to be wanting. What I'm saying is like a lion just attacking you, wanting to suck up all your energy. Let them. They need it. They're in a very, very creative, transformative phase right now, and they need all the power. Okay. Alright, I love you. That was your reading for Libra season. Take care of yourself.